I miss my family. Is my house built on rock or on sand? If it stands on the rock, it is well. It seems easy enough while one sits here alone. And one thinks one has done all that God commands. But as soon as I cease to be on my guard, I sin again. Still, I will persevere. It brings such joy. Help me, O Lord. He gave no water for his feet, gave no kiss, his head with oil, and he did not anoint. He must have been like me, that Pharisee. He too thought only of himself, how to get a cup of tea, how to keep warm and comfortable, never a thought of his guest. He took care of himself, but for his guest, he cared nothing at all. Yet, who was the guest? The Lord himself. If he came to me, should I behave like that?
Martin.
Who's there?
Martin. Look out into the street tomorrow, for I shall come.
strange voice sounds real, but I don't understand. A bit. I'm sure you must be cold.
May God bless you. My bones don't ache.
Come, friend. Sit down. Have some tea. Here. Have another glass. Are you expecting anyone? Am I expecting anyone? Well, now I'm ashamed to tell you. It isn't that I really expect anyone, but I heard something last night which I can't get out of my mind. Whether it was a vision or only a fancy, I can't tell. You see, my friend, last night I was reading the gospel about Christ the Lord, how he suffered and how he walked on earth. You have heard tell of it, I dare say.
I have heard tell of it, but I'm ignorant and not able to read.
Well, you see, I was reading of how he walked on earth. I came to the part, you know, where he went to a Pharisee who did not receive him well. Well, friend, as I read about it, I thought, now that the man did not receive Christ the Lord with proper honors, suppose such a thing could happen to such a man as myself. I thought, what would I not do to receive him? But that man gave him no reception. At all. Well, friend, as I was thinking of this, I began to doze. And as I dozed, I heard someone call me by name. I got up and thought I heard someone whispering, said, "Expect me, I will come tomorrow." This happened while over. And to tell you the truth, it sat so in my mind that though I am ashamed of it myself, I keep on expecting him, the dear Lord. Here, drink another glass. Bless you. And I was thinking too, how he walked on earth and despised no one but went mostly among common people. He went with plain people and chose his disciples from among the likes of us, from workmen like us, sinners that we are. He who raises himself, he said, shall be humbled, and he who humbled himself shall be raised. You call me Lord, he said, and I will wash your feet. He who would be first, he said, let him be the servant of all, because
said, blessed are the poor, the humble, and the merciful.
Come, drink some more.
Thank you, Martin Abich. You have given me food and comfort for body and soul.
You're very welcome. Come again another time, and I am glad to have you as my guest.
There with the baby in the pool. Come inside. We can wrap him up better in a warm place. Come this way.
Sit down and eat, my dear. And I'll mind the baby. For I have children on my own. And I know how to manage them.
I'm a soldier's wife. They sent my husband somewhere far away. 8 months ago, and I have heard nothing of him since. I had worked as cook till my baby was born, but then they would not keep me with a child. For 3 months now, I have been struggling, unable to find place, and I have to sell all I had for food. I tried to go as wet nurse, but no one would help me. They said I was too starved looking and thin. Now I have just been to see a trained smart's wife, and she has promised to take me. I thought it was all settled at last, but she tells me not to come till next week. It is far to her place, and I am bored out, and baby is quite starved. Poor Mike. Fortunately, our landlady has pity on us. And let us lunch free. Else I don't know what we should do.
Don't you have any warmer clothing?
How could I get warm clothing? I found my last shawl for money yesterday.
Here, it will do wrap him up.
The Lord blessed you, friend. Surely Christ must have sent me to your window. Else the child would have frozen. It was mild when I started, but now see how good it has turned. Surely it must have been Christ who made you look out your window and take pity on me, poor wretch.
It is quite true. It was He made me do it. It was no mere chance made me look out.
Who knows? All things are possible.
Take this, for Christ's sake.
Hey boy, keep back my apple.
I didn't take it. Why are you beating me for? Let me go.
Let him go, Granny. Forgive him, for Christ's sake.
I'll pay him cut so that he won't forget it for a year. I'll take this rascal to the police.
Forgive him, Granny. He won't do it again. Let him go, for Christ's sake. You don't do it again. Ask Granny's forgiveness and don't do it again. I saw you took the apple.
I'm sorry, Granny. Please forgive me.
That's right. And now, here's the apple for you. And I will pay you, Granny.
You will spoil them that way. The young rascals, he needs to be whipped so that he should remember it for a week.
Oh, Granny, Granny, that's our way. But it's not God's way. If he should be whipped for stealing an apple, what should be done for our sins? God bids us forgiveness, or else we shall not be forgiven. Forgive everyone, and a thoughtless youngster must of all.
It's true enough, but they are getting terribly spoiled.
Then we old ones must show them better ways.
That's just what I say, of course. It was only his childness. May God help him.
Let me carry it for you, Granny. I'm going that way too. Time to light up.
Martin, don't you know me? Who is it?
It is I.
It is I.
It is I.
It is I.